it's evac time for another video here at Evacs. Yeah. Talk about entertainment and movies and television shows. Yeah, I feel like I'm more in my element. Sobrang kinabahan ako in my last video for all the right reasons because I didn't want to make, you know, a mistake. I'm excited to be talking about a series that is going to come out with its season 2 sa Netflix. Yeah. On July 31, Umbrella Academy. I think we're alone now. And since it's top 3 Fridays, I'm going to give you yung top 3 characters. Okay, so what is Umbrella Academy all about? Umbrella Academy focuses on a family, if you will, or a group of superheroes, okay? With special abilities. In the year 1989.
In October 1989, 43 women around the world gave birth. None of these women had been pregnant when the day first began.
This guy by the name of Sir Reginald Hargreaves, who was a billionaire, adopted 7 out of these 43 children and trained them, and as they grew up, he mentored them and they showed powers and a certain unique ability that is unique to themselves. By the way, Umbrella Academy is based on a graphic novel, so you may actually want to read that as well before or while you watch the series. So I'll be talking about the Hargreaves children and I won't be giving in-depth thoughts yet about the plot because I want you to watch season 1 for yourselves. When we watch season 2 all together, I'll give my rundown and thoughts about the story, the plot, and the overall flow of the series. But I'll just be talking about the characters for the meantime. I will be rating them. Okay, so I guess it's easier. The 7, 6, 5, and 4 are in no particular order, so I'll just jumble them up. So, this doesn't necessarily mean if I mention you first, you're the lowest, okay? So that's what we always say to our students, for them not to feel bad. One of those that make the top 3 is Luther Vandross. When I was a child. Back when I was a child. Luther Hargreaves, also known as Space Boy. We find out in season 1 that he's been to space and comes back to Earth and is half ape, half man. Like here down is, you know, like he's a biologically engineered superhero. So he has amazing strength. So kind of like the Hulk. So all superhero groups need someone with a, you know, big physique. But his big physique is actually also because of his ape-like body. For me, I love the idea of having someone like that. And there's a complexity to his character that meron parang emotional, parang may PSD din siya. Yung character niya. But I just don't feel like that is a power I would want. But it's cool that he's added into the mix because it's also a great, parang may great chemistry yung, know, physicality niya, and then the other powers that are in play. Next, okay, I'll talk about this guy. He didn't make it to the top 3, but his superpower is cool as well. In this Funko Pop, you'll actually see he looks like a kid, and then the others are like full-grown adults. And it's because he was able to travel to a post-apocalyptic future. And then he's recruited by an organization, turns on them so that he can get back to his real timeline But when he does get back, his body, or he's transported to his younger body. So I think it's cool, but there's no mastery yet of his powers. But I love how he's very central to the whole Umbrella Academy series. Next is Diego, okay, the brother of Dora. Diego Hargreaves, who is able to curve objects that he throws, usually knives.
Guns are for sissies. Real men throw knives.
It moves in a certain direction that he wants. So it's kind of like Wanted. I put him here in like not in the top three because there's still more that I want to see from Diego's character. I feel like it wasn't well expounded on in the first season, so hopefully they still get to focus more on him and probably evolve his character's development further along. So now we're down to four. We have someone who barely, I'm already telling you, she was number four. It's Vanya. Okay, Vanya, who is also known as the White Violin. Oh, by the way, they have names. Okay, so see, Luther Hargreaves, known as Space Boy. Diego Hargreaves is known as the Kraken. But then number five is the boy. Vanya is known as the White Violin. So she is like, she should have made the top three, but then I still want a bit more from her character because it was also a bit open-ended. She is like a Dark Phoenix from the X-Men movies. She's like Jean Grey. Throughout the film, she has like no powers at all. But apparently it's because it's suppressed by something. Later on, we find out the full spectrum of her abilities, and it's due to sound waves. That's why she's known as the White Violin. She plays the violin. Love the look of it in the latter part of the season. It was so cool to see her really showcase the power. But now it comes down to the top three. Number three, I feel it goes to Klaus Hargreaves. I love him as a character, and superpower wise, probably still better powers in the film or in the series than him. But I love the like Jack Sparrow vibes I get from Klaus. So kudos to Robert Sheehan for an amazing performance with Klaus. Klaus is known as the Seance and is a drug addict and an alcoholic, but he's actually using that to suppress his powers as well. Because his superpower is actually creepy, he's able to communicate with the dead.
I see dead people.
What's cool about it is his overall appearance and his overall style and swag. Like I said, it looks like a Jack Sparrow ripoff, but I love it. It's so cool. He adds flavor to the whole group in terms of your acting style, then character development. Yeah, it's brilliant. I feel like he is supposed to be in the top three. Number two is, we don't have a lot of screen time with this character, but I love to see what they're gonna do with him in season two. Excited enough all to see where we're gonna go with Ben Hargreaves, but I love the idea of being able to, you know, expel alien tentacles out of your body on purpose, not like the movie Aliens.
Oh God!
Love his unique position. We learn actually in season one that Ben, and this is a given, okay? Ben, who's also called as the Horror, is dead. And the only one who's able to communicate with him is the guy who has that power. So we don't see much of Ben because of that, but we do get glimpses of him because of Klaus's superpower. So we have a good tandem with Ben and Klaus, and we're able to see as well a complex character with a very unique and complex situation. A lot of the Netflix series have a lot of diversity. So Ben is Asian, and then, or looks Asian, I think he's Asian, right? Confirmed? And we have like African Americans and all. So I love the diversity and how they do that also in other series. number one spot, favorite character so far, Allison Hargreaves, called or referred to as the Rumor. So she's a famous actress who's able to control other human beings by saying the phrase,
I heard that you shot your friend.
What the hell?
So for example, she says, rumor has it, you punched yourself in the face.
I heard a rumor. You punched yourself in the face.
I like her character, and there's a certain tension between her and Luther, but I love the certain vibes that she brings in the powerful, like, woman feels. You don't have to agree with me with my list. You can have certain numbers for each and every one of them. But I do encourage you to watch The Umbrella Academy. Overall feels of it, even some of the songs are really catchy, and I love the way that they picked their soundtrack. It's actually from a scene in, I think, the first episode where Luther plays that song and they all dance in different rooms and in their own way. It's so cool. Love the treatment of it. And I'll give my thoughts further about this eventually as we go along. So comment down below your thoughts about my top three characters. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to make every day into an adventure. That's all here at A-Vlogs. Bye, guys.